G'day and welcome back to Buildsum. And in this video, I'm going to start looking at what we call a long section. So the main reason we would take a long section is if we're going to work out, say we're going to dig a pipeline or a trench and we want to work out how much material we need to excavate, then we do a long section. And a long section is basically, we do a straight line survey of an area. And then from that and from our readings, we can calculate and plot the actual shape of the ground, and then we can work out our excavation. Okay, so here's our block of land, and this is the trench that we want to dig. It's about 50 meters long, and obviously the ground's not level, so the ground's a bit up and down, and our trench has a bit of a slope to it because we're going to put a sewage pipe or a stormwater pipe in here that needs to have a bit of fall. Okay, so to do our long section, the first thing we need to do is what we call a straight line survey. So we need to actually break this trench, if you like, up into an even points. And the closer together those points, the more accurate your long section is going to be at the end. Okay, so I've just gone with 5 meters. I mean, you could go 10 meters depending on the overall length of the trench and the overall detail that you want to have on your long section. Yeah, but 5 meters is pretty good. So I've identified from the start of where the trench starts to the end, I've broken that up into reasonably, you know, even points, and that's where we're going to take our readings. If your trench was 52 meters long, it's not really going to matter. As long as the majority of your readings are evenly spaced, and then you just have whatever the leftover is at the end, you can work with that. Okay, so I've identified or spaced out my readings. Obviously, I've got to identify what my readings are going to be. So, you know, 0.1 through to 11 in this case, so we can have A, B, and C. And the other thing we need to do a long section is we need to know a height. Okay, so there's our readings. We obviously, when we do our survey for our long section, we've got to get back to a datum of some sort. Benchmark or a datum on our job site. All right, so we're going to do our survey, a straight line survey, to our starting with our datum, and then all our points along our trench. We don't have to close the survey, although it's good if you can, just as a check. But you just take the reading of all those points, and then we're going to put that in the level book and create a long section from that.
Okay, so we've been out on site and we've done our readings, and we can then put them into our level book. Doesn't matter whether it's rise and fall or height of collimation, but we need to produce an RL for each of the readings that we took. So we had 11 readings. I've now got 11 RLs. You'll need to make up a bit of a graph that looks something like this. There's a table at the bottom and just some graph lines across the top. But I'll show you what they're for in a sec. But the first thing we're going to record is what we call the surface RL. So that's basically the RL of the reading or the points that we've taken off our level book. So these RLs here, so the RL for point one is 30.212. It just goes into that column there in the surface RL row. And we just go along and we put all those RLs straight in to our graph. So we have an RL for each of the points of our long section. Okay, so once we've done that, we can get rid of our level book. We don't need that anymore. And then we're going to actually plot where these go on our graph up here. So what I've done, I've said that this is going to be 28. I've had a little bit of a look at my readings, and I know that we're not going to have anything less than an RL of 28, even when we put our trench in here. So I'm going to set this baseline at 28, because just below that is nothing. So we're not going to need it. And we can scale this up, or in this case, I've just broken my graph up into some equal sections. So I'm going to say that this is 29, has an RL of 29 on this line. This line here has an RL of 30. You can keep going if you want, but I don't need to, because we're not going to be much over 30. But the other option is you can just scale these up with a scale ruler if you need to, okay? So what I'm going to do, I've got my RL here of 30.212, and my baseline is 28. So the difference between that is 2.212. So if I had a scale ruler, I would just scale 2 meters, 212, up this line to, and you'll just have to pick a scale which fits on your page, okay? So, but I've said here that I'm going to go 30.212. So I'm going to be up around here somewhere. So I'm just going to put a mark on my graph to represent that. So this one here is 30.378. So that's going to be slightly higher than this mark. So I'm going to put a line there. And 30.429, again, it's going to be slightly higher than this one. And then this one's exactly the same as that one. So I'm just going to come down to the same level. This one's coming down. So 125 is going to be just above this line here. And then we're going 29.837. So I'm going to be below the line. Okay, so I'm actually just trying to create a representation of where those points are on the ground. You can see I'm starting to get a bit of a representation of the shape of the ground. As I said, these could be scaled up, or you can just plot them, break up the graph evenly and plot them. We're just looking for a look of the ground. I mean, it's not going to be a great representation because obviously the scale going this way is not going to be the same as the scale going this way. All right? We're only talking, this is 50 meters long this way and we're only 2 meters high that way. So the scale is never going to work. So the next one, 29. It's a little bit lower than this one, 29.5, so we're halfway down that line. This is below half, so we're a little bit below the halfway point on that line. 29.6, we're going up again. 29.9, we're going to be virtually touching that line. And 29.81, it's just a little bit lower than that, okay? So I've plotted all those points, and then I can join them together. You can do straight lines, but you know straight lines aren't natural, so just do a nice freehand curve. And that will give you a representation of the slope of the ground. Remembering the shape of the trench from the start, it did start up high at the start and then it went down through a dip and it came up at the end. So we have just a representation of what the ground actually looks like. So that's plotting the long section and getting the representation of the Earth's surface or the natural surface, natural RLs. In the next video, we'll go through actually plotting a trench and actually getting to see and work out the depths of the trench at each of these points. G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.